Hello everyone, my name is Demismu, and this is my assistant the Foot. Today we'll talk about Democritus. Democritus was a proponent of the theory of atomism. As with the other Pre-Socratics, Democritus wanted to find the principle, or ARCHE, of the world. In his view, the world can be explained as a congregation of atoms. Long before modern physics, Democritus introduced particles as elements of everything that is. All that is a combination of atoms. An atom, or atomos, is the Greek word for indivisible. An atom is an individual. It cannot be divided further. There is an infinite number of atoms according to Democritus, and all of them are the same. They are all made of the same stuff. The only difference between them is in their shape and size. Every single atom has a different shape, and they are like snowflakes in this way. Each one is special. Since there is an infinite number of different shapes, some atoms will have hooks, others will have holes, and atoms with hooks and holes will attach to each other. Given a particular arrangement, you get different things on the macro level. Now, how did everything come into being in the first place? Well, Democritus thought that our world emerged from a vortex of atoms. So a bunch of atoms formed a great vortex, and all of them collided with each other, pushing, bouncing off of each other and sticking to each other. They did this in the void, which is simply that where atoms are not. And they moved at random, chaotically, but the closer they got to each other, the more dense they became, so they got entangled with each other with their hooks and holes. Heavier atoms congregated at the center, while the lighter ones on the perimeter, and this gave birth to the Earth and our world. But since the movement of atoms is completely random, another vortex of atoms could result in a different world. In other words, there is no particular reason why atoms would form only such a world as ours. And indeed, in void, they might form countless different worlds. And Democritus thought that this was the case. There are many worlds, emerging from many different vortexes of atoms. This is the first idea of what we today would call the multiverse theory. Thus, depending on what kind of atoms congregate in what particular way, there are many unique type of worlds. Some have life, as ours does. Others don't. In some world, philosophers might appear as a specific combination of atoms. In others, they will not. Now, all of this accounts for material stuff, like earth, rocks, water, or air. But what about the mind? In a world where only atoms exist, where does thought, consciousness, and all that stuff come from? Well, Democritus thought that there is a special class of atoms, soul atoms, which are spherical and diffused across the whole of the human body. Basically, mind is a concentration of soul atoms. Since there is nothing but atoms in void, perception, like seeing or hearing, all result from interaction between atoms. In other words, all senses are reducible to one central sense, touch, since touching is most closely related to what actually takes place on the level of atoms. So for example, when you see something, what actually takes place at the level of atoms is that the atoms from the outside touch and impress themselves on the soul atoms inside that make out the mind. So when you observe something, the mechanism of seeing is in fact that of atoms coming into contact with each other. This means it follows that we can never be absolutely sure of what we are perceiving or thinking. Truth is at the level of atoms, since there is nothing else but atoms in void and their interactions. What we see or think is a result of these interactions, and we only get this result. What we see or hear, sense or imagine, all of this depends on the interaction of atoms which we cannot get to, since they remain in the depths. Democritus, therefore, was skeptical of our ability to know anything with certainty. Thank you very much, and until next time.